Today is September 27th, and the news starts now.
Good morning, Anoka. I'm Lacey.
And I'm Mr. Mans. It's hump day here at Anoka, and here we go with the news. At 7 p.m. tonight, the Fieldhouse, our Academic All-Stars Academic Lettering Ceremony. This event celebrates students who rocked their studies last year by maintaining impressive GPAs. Targets were 3.9 GPA for freshmen, 3.85 for sophomores, 3.8 for last year's juniors. If you hit this mark, congratulations.
If you're one of those academic lettermen or just someone looking for a great school to attend, the University of Wisconsin-Stout will be offering on-the-spot admission at Anoka on next Monday, October 2nd. Students participating will be able to apply for free, get an admissions decision on the same day, and be entered into a drawing for a $1,000 scholarship. Interested students should see Ms. Neary in the Career Center to sign up. Really, if you have any questions about college or post-high school work life, connect with Ms. Neary as there's a ton of options and opportunities available.
There are also tons of opportunities for clubs tonight. We have Host a Club Meeting, Step Dance, Tornado Service Club, Tornado Force, and of course, Tornado Tales Book Club, all taking place this evening. On top of that, Educators Rising is holding their first meeting tonight. Educators Rising is a club for aspiring teachers, or those interested in learning more about teaching. Mrs. Hale is the advisor, and we have an amazing crew this year. We go on field trips, get to work with kids, and have a blast working together. Check it out in the Facts Wing in FC155. Lighthouse is also taking place tonight down in room SC171. If you need some help with your studies from teachers, this is the place to go on Wednesday. Tomorrow morning, Tornado Force is taking place in the weight room, and Bibles for Breakfast is having their third breakfast. Here's more info on Bibles and Breakfast.
And I am with Ray Fritz.
Lexi.
And both of them are a part of Bibles and Breakfast, which is a club here at Anoka High School. And I'm just wondering if you could tell me a little bit about Bibles for Breakfast.
I just really feel like students are searching for truth, and they want to know purpose and direction in their lives, and we felt like the Bible gives that to them.
All right, cool. Can you tell me a little bit about the breakfast part of it? What was on the menu for today?
Today we had Pizza Ranch, and we usually have things like Nautical Bowls, Pizza Ranch, Chick-fil-A, and Pappy's, and I think we're going to get more soon.
Cool. And then for students who are wanting to come, can you tell me a little bit about when they would come down here?
There's nothing they need to do to sign up. It helps on Instagram if they join on Instagram and let us know they're coming. And anybody's welcome. We love having anybody from any walk or any background at all.
Cool. What got you to come to Bibles for Breakfast?
My best friend started going to Bibles and Breakfast, so then they invited me, and my friend even drove me a couple of times, and now I can drive by myself, so I'm trying to make it every single week, but yeah, it's really cool, the whole situation.
All right, excellent. So there you have it. That's Bibles for Breakfast.
Looking ahead, more new clubs are starting up here at Anoka. Art Club is having their first meeting next Monday, October 2nd, after school in A241, from 2:30 to 3:30. Art Club t-shirts where students can bring in cotton shirts to bleach, tie-dye, or paint on. If students don't have a shirt to use, then we have a few extras. Next Tuesday, October 3rd, Black Student Union will be starting their club for the year, and they'd love for you to come down and see what it's about.
That's all for club news. Remember, if you have a club or activity you want highlighted on the news, email us at AnokaTVNews@ahschools.us. Now, let's turn over to the sports crew.
There was a lot happening in the Northwest Conference last night, but let's start with the girls' swim and dive team, senior night. Huge shout out to our seniors girls for giving it their all during our senior night. And through the last few years, congrats to Anya Day, Tegan Gordy, Grace Morphew, Anna Tyler, Lydia Lackinen, Jordan Ritamir Brown, Hannah Hong, and Molly Newman. For the senior girls, they had a tough matchup as the girls took on a talented Rebels team. The meet came down to an exciting last relay where Anoka needed to get first and second in order to win. Anoka got first and a very close third to lose the meet by two. Champlain Park 94, Anoka 92. Huge performances by Nora Sloth, Grace Morphew, Cindy DeRung, Mackenzie Solberg, Sarah Hogue, Emma Schmitz, Abby Johnson, Sarah Jensen, Lydia Lakanen, and many more kept Anoka in close contention for the entire meet. Across the river in Champlain, the Anoka boys fell to the Rebels 2-1 in what felt like a fast-paced, intense night of action. The girls fared a bit better. In the defensive struggle, the game was tied 0-0 until the last minute of the game. After Gardner had her shot on goal blocked by the Champlain keeper, Anoka took it in on a side kick with a beautiful set up from the corner kick from Danner. Gardner elevates and puts it in the corner of the net to send Anoka into victory mode 1-0 over Champlain. While there aren't any varsity games happening tonight, Thursday will see a full slate of action with the girls volleyball team taking on Blaine and the boys and girls soccer teams hosting senior night at Goodrich Field. And this weekend, the soccer team will host the second annual Halloween Cup this Saturday afternoon from 1 to 6 p.m. at Goodrich Field. There will be food trucks, swag giveaways, Ghostbuster photo ops, pep band, free black pom-poms, and so much more. We want to pack the bleachers for this game. The theme is blackout, so dress up and get to Goodrich Field on Saturday. That's all for the sports. Back to the news desk.
Thanks, Chase. It's hard to believe that many sports are already entering the final stretch of the regular season. Get out and support your classmates before the season ends.
Another way you can support your community is by giving blood. Did you know that 20% of all donated blood comes from high schoolers? Be a part of that percentage and sign up for BPA's blood drive taking place this Friday in the Fieldhouse. Our goal for this year is 92 units of blood. The sign up to donate is taking place during all lunches. Students must be 17 or years of age or older and must also meet some weight requirements based on height. Because blood cannot be synthetically produced, there is no substitute. Only volunteer donors can save lives. Please encourage your friends to sign up to be a donor.
That's all for news today. Before we go, today's lunch is Pizza Crunchers, Chicken Ranch Wraps, or Fiesta Chicken. I'm Lacey.
And I'm Mr. Manns, the man with the plan. We're on the far side of this week, Anoka.
Peace out.
Bye.
Let's go. If you a fly girl, get your nails done. Get a pedicure, get your hair done. See, you're telling me I'm pretty, but it's obvious. I don't need a man to tell me where the party is. If you a fly girl, get your nails done. Get a pedicure, get your hair done. See, you're telling me I'm pretty, but it's obvious. I don't need a man to tell me where the party is.
Checklist, take it off, what you got? Pricey, so you better have a fly.
Just shoot.